What's up, everybody? Jesse here with a quick update. Yesterday, I reported on news from an interview between Aonoma and a French website, Le Monde, or however it's pronounced. The video is filled with tons of new info involving Breath of the Wild. During part of this interview, Aonoma talks about dungeons and shrines. He mentions that some shrines will be a lot longer than others and will have a boss at the end. He also mentions how themed dungeons will not be returning to the game. For instance, a dungeon found in the desert may not necessarily be desert themed. The dungeons were just a small part of the full interview. But after posting this video, I received a lot of comments from people disappointed at the lack of these traditionally themed dungeons. Some of the most memorable features in Zelda games happen to be the themed dungeons, and most of these dungeons take inspiration from the area that it's located in. For instance, most fire-themed dungeons are found near Death Mountain, and most water dungeons are found near Lake Hylia. It just makes sense, and it's an easy way to have each dungeon feel unique in its own way. So with this in mind, it's very clear why many fans were upset. I mean, if we go into each of these 120 shrines, and every single one has the same exact blue atmosphere, it'll just get boring and feel repetitive. It may even drive some fans away from completing them all. Well, I received one comment from Michael Mansfield that reads, "The part about no traditional dungeons is false. Based on a poor translation, Aonuma was specifically talking about shrines, and says that there are in fact real dungeons in the world apart from them." So I looked into it, and as it turns out, this was partially a mess up in translation, as the original interview was posted in French, which means Aonuma's words were translated from Japanese to French. The interviewer and Aonuma's already translated words were translated again to English. So it's easy to see how some things were misinterpreted. Now, I can't read French or Japanese, but Google can. So I relied on it to translate and filled in the gaps. It's important to note that temple, sanctuary, palace, and shrine can all be used as synonyms of one another, as they are all places of worship, and the Zelda series has used each of these three names to describe dungeons. For example, almost every dungeon in Zelda 2 and a few in A Link to the Past are referred to as palaces, with the beginning dungeon in A Link to the Past leading you to a sanctuary. Ocarina of Time and other Zelda games have used the word temple to describe dungeons. Now, Breath of the Wild is using shrines. So again, it is very easy to see how a slight misunderstanding could happen. Besides, I'm pretty sure we've already seen two of these themed traditional dungeons before. The fire dungeon from the Switch trailer, which you can see here, then the outside of the swamp or forest themed dungeon during the Game Awards Let's Play with the goddess statue at the entrance. In fact, I think these major shrines or fully themed dungeons will each have a goddess statue near it to unlock Link's memories. We even see one glowing in the Temple of Time, which we know from Twilight Princess also contains a dungeon. So here is a direct translation from Google. The interviewer asks, "Previously, for each dungeon, you start with a specific theme and object, such as fire and bomb, water and bow, and so on. Now that you have dozens of dungeons, how do you keep the variety?" Aonuma replied, "There are more than 100, in fact. We no longer speak of dungeons, in quotes, but of sanctuaries." Alright, so see, right there, we're just at the very first sentence, and we already have another mix-up in translation. For the English audience, we know that these are called shrines, not sanctuaries. Anyways, he goes on to say that if they were all long and complicated, the players would probably never finish the game, so we wanted them to be rewards rather than trials in themselves. Then here we get another mix-up in translation, "The fun is greatly to the find," which obviously doesn't make any sense in English, but I think you can roughly translate that to part of the fun being finding these very well hidden shrines. He then goes on to say they're very different from those of previous Zelda games, though some are much larger and have a boss at the end in more of a traditional way. So right there tells us that yes, there will be traditional dungeons in this game, but not all 120 of these shrines will be traditional dungeons. Then he says, "On the other hand, we do not do as before. If a temple was in a forest, it was made the dungeon of the forest. Now they are designed to make progress, and Link are all built on a very similar basis, but using the engine physics of the game to offer challenging puzzles." So here's what I think that last paragraph means. So a lot of people, myself included, took when he said we no longer speak of dungeons, as this game will only have shrines, and every shrine we've seen so far has had the same blue atmosphere, so we simply thought no traditional dungeons. But the interviewer specifically asked about traditional dungeons themed around certain weapons, like the Fire Temple in Ocarina of Time being based around the Megaton Hammer. Aonuma answers this by saying the physics engine will allow you to complete these dungeons, or in this game, the shrines, in multiple different ways, which is something we know from past interviews, that there isn't just one specific way to complete a puzzle or a shrine, that you can go about them and solve puzzles in several different ways. When he says that dungeons won't necessarily be themed around the location that it's in, I take this as Let's say Death Mountain has 8 shrines near it. Not every shrine will be a fire or mountain themed dungeon. Maybe 6 or 7 will look like normal shrines with the same blue atmosphere, but 1 or 2 of them, which could be the longer dungeons he mentions with the bosses at the end, will be themed on that area. So these are just my thoughts, but let me know what you think of all this. We know this game has 120 shrines, so if we can, I would like to see 100 normal shrines and 20 themed shrines. What's up everybody, really quick before we get to the usual end slate, I wanted to mention a quick update for this channel. I'm trying to bring together a few new series other than the usual discussions and news videos that we do. I would like to bring quality reviews, let's plays, do more live streams, a top 10 series, and more analysis videos. However, to do this, I need your help. Between being a new father, YouTube, and my real job, I don't have the time to work on all of these videos. So I'd like to bring on other people who can help out from time to time, like Sasizi and others who have helped host and edit videos before. To make this all happen, and to get awesome rewards for yourself, head over to patreon.com/gameoverjesse where you can get shoutouts and videos, join our group Discord and chat with us whenever you want, be a guest on some of our videos, and much more. I want to thank you all for watching this video. If you liked it, give this video a like and share it with your friends. If you haven't already, please subscribe so you don't miss out on future gaming news, theories, rumors, and discussions. Also, let me know your thoughts in the comments below on how it could be improved. Your feedback is the most important part of bringing the quality of content on this channel to be the best that it can be. I would like to take this time to give a huge thank you to this month's Patreon supporters, Jonathan, The Edge Network, Magic Tech Review, John Frank, and Harris Priest. This video was made possible by supporters on Patreon. If you would also like to support this channel, head over to patreon.com/gameoverjesse where you can support this channel as well. Rewards vary from having your topic featured on a future discussion, seeing videos early, joining as a guest on a video, shoutout, and having a custom avatar similar to my own drawn of you to match any video game or anime art style that you would like. Mine is of myself as Link, but you could choose to have yours any way that you would like. Finally, I would like to thank my friends CSGuitar89 and Nomo Designs for providing the music and artwork for this video.